Postnatal exercises should be started after delivery as soon as the mother is comfortable in order to improve circulation, strengthen the pelvic floor and abdominal muscles, prevent long-term complications such as backache or uterine prolapse, and regain the physical and mental stability of the mother. So in this video, I am going to teach you the postnatal exercises and when it should be started, both after normal delivery and cesarean section. Hello everyone, welcome back to Ananya's Nursing Tutorial. So without delay, let's start the postnatal exercises. So the first exercise is foot exercise. Foot and ankle exercises must be performed very frequently as soon as possible, both after normal delivery and cesarean section, to improve circulation, reduce edema and prevent deep vein thrombosis. Bend and stretch the ankles up and down for 30 seconds and then circle both feet 10 times in each direction. So clockwise 10 times and anti-clockwise 10 times. Abdominal breathing. Deep abdominal breathing is very important to strengthen the diaphragm. It should be started from second day in both normal delivery and cesarean section. The mother is taught to take a deep breath, raising her abdominal wall and then exhale slowly. She could place one hand on the abdomen and one hand on chest and make sure that the hand on the abdomen should be raised but the hand on the chest should remain stationary. So you could repeat process 5 times. The next one is pelvic tilting. It can be started from second day after normal delivery and third or fourth day after cesarean section. Lie flat on the floor with knees bent and feet flat. Inhale first and then exhale slowly, flattening the back against the floor and tighten the muscles of the abdomen and buttocks also. You have to press the back in such a way that there is no space in between the back and the floor. And then inhale slowly, hold for 10 seconds and relax. The next one is knee rolling. It can also be started from second day in normal delivery and third or fourth day in cesarean section. But make sure there is no undue separation of rectus muscle or any other complication. In back lying with knees bent, pull in the abdomen and roll both knees to one side comfortably, keeping the shoulders flat. Then return the knees to upright position and relax. Again pull in and roll both knees to the other side. You can do this up to 10 times. The shoulder should not turn while the knees are turning. Pelvic tilting and knee rolling are very useful to ease backache and flatulence in the postnatal period. The next one is pelvic floor exercises or Kegel exercise. In case of normal delivery, Kegel exercises can be started from third day and continued for 3 months. In cesarean section, this can be started after 5 to 7 days if there is no complication and the mother feels comfortable. The pelvic floor muscles have been under strain during pregnancy and stressed during normal delivery, and thus the pelvic floor exercises are very important during the postnatal period. It helps to regain full bladder control, prevent uterine prolapse and ensure normal sexual satisfaction in future. Close and draw up around the anal passages as though preventing a bowel action, and then same in the vaginal and urethral passages as if to stop the flow of urine. Hold for as long as possible up to 10 seconds and breathing normally and then relax. You can do it up to 5 to 10 times. The next one is head and shoulder raising. In normal delivery, it can be started from second or third postpartum day and after 5 to 7 days in cesarean section. Mother should lie flat without pillow and raise head until the chin is touching the chest. After doing this for 2 to 3 days, the mother should try to raise both head and shoulders of the bed and lower them slowly. The next one is leg raising. This exercise can be started from the 7th postpartum day in normal delivery and after 15 days in cesarean section. If there is any problem in doing this exercise, the mother should ask any medical personnel for advice. Lie down on the floor with no pillows under head, point toe and slowly raise one leg, keeping the knee straight, and then lower the leg slowly. You can do it 5 to 10 times in each leg. And the last one is hip hitching. Hip hitching can be done after 3 to 4 days of normal delivery and 7 to 8 days after cesarean section. The mother should lie on back with one knee bent and the other knee straight. Slide the heel of the straight leg downwards as if lengthening the leg, keeping the abdomen pulled in. Then shorten the leg by drawing the hip upwards on the same side. Then repeat it to the other side. So these are all about postnatal exercises. I hope you found this video useful. If you have any query, let me know in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you have not done it yet.